Good morning, everyone. How are you? Welcome to Eco Happiness TV from the Eco Happiness Project. Today, I want to talk to you about something really fun I just did with my kids last week. We went blueberry picking. We have a family tradition every June when we're up here in New Jersey to head over to a local blueberry farm and to pick our own fresh blueberries. Check them out. Aren't they gorgeous? We actually came home with like three bowls the amount to fill three bowls this size, and they are gorgeous and delicious, and it was just such an amazing time, and I wanted to talk to you all about that. So on my blog, I wrote on my website, I wrote a blog in the fall about you pick ways to enjoy the fall, including you pick farms. And so I wanted to reinvigorate that and apply it to this time of year. So it all depends on where you are and how close you are to different kinds of agricultural locations and farms. Here in New Jersey, believe it or not, they have tons of blueberries. New Jersey produces about 40 to 50 million pounds of blueberries every year, generating $60 to $70 million in revenues. And the majority of these blueberry farms are actually in South Jersey, which is where we are near the beach. And so it's a really fun tradition. And I bet you didn't know when you think of New Jersey that we have a lot of blueberries and cranberries too. There's actually a lot of agriculture here. So this whole idea of, what in the world does going blueberry picking have to do with feeling happier and calmer and our mental health, right? Well, let me tell you, it was such a relaxing activity to do with my kids. We spent about an hour or so in the fields. It wasn't quite too, it wasn't a hot day, but it was a little, got a little warm in the sun, but the wind was blowing and you could just feel it against our skin. I remember my daughter saying, "Oh, do you hear the wind and do you feel it?" So this whole concept of being outside in nature and doing an activity like this is such a mindful, relaxing experience. So how does it bring us mindfulness? Well, some of the reasons was that, again, my kids were so quiet. They were concentrating and so focused on picking the right blueberries because you have to really go through and see like what are the ripe ones to take. And the darker, the better. So also, as you're doing this, you're concentrating, you're absorbing and enjoying these colors. These blueberries ranged from a green to light blue. They're very dark blue, like you end up seeing here, in the grocery store, and also even purples. And then, of course, the gorgeous green of the leaves that surround them as they're growing in the farm. And looking up at the blue sky, there's so much to look at and to really feel mindful about. And then also there was we were it was just so quiet and serene. We were one of the few families that were there at the time, and we could hear the birds chirping in the background. And again, the wind howling a little bit. And as the wind blew, you could hear the little rustling of the trees and the bushes, the leaves of the plants. And so it was just like the opposite of our daily experiences with so much noise and distractions. So it was just such a pleasant time to be out there. The other thing is when you pop that blueberry in your mouth, and of course, when you're in the field, you have to taste a few, right? And just that sensation of the sweet juice just popping in your mouth is just, again, a really mindful experience. And you can do this again, depending on where you live and how close you are in the season. Other you picks that we've done through the year, or in the fall in the Northeast, we've gone apple picking, we've gone raspberry picking. Of course, during Halloween, you can go to a pumpkin patch and pick out your favorite orange treasure for the holiday. And so, there's so much you can do with the senses. You're hearing the sounds of nature. You're tasting the the amazing produce that you're finding. You are, touching it and smelling it. And so this is just a wonderful little trick to get your kids interested also in healthy foods. And as we know, and as you'll find, I have a whole chapter in my upcoming book, Finding Eco Happiness, that comes out next March. And it's a whole book dedicated to food, where we talk about the benefits of certain foods to help us feel happier and calmer, known to help with stress reduction. And then I also include ideas about gardening with your family and other, like going to farmers markets and YouPicks. And so an entire chapter dedicated to the connection between nature, food, which is part of nature, and stress reduction. So again, I encourage you, especially this summer, if you're looking for a fun activity with your family, to do some Googling and find out where there are some local farms in your area. And if not now, maybe in the fall, or depending again on where you live in the world, it could be your winter. And head out there. And again, you can go over to ecohappinessproject.com and you can find more information about fun activities for your families, for your family to enjoy together outside with nature. Well, I'm off to make myself a banana blueberry smoothie. Doesn't that just sound so refreshing? I know a lot of people today are having a heat wave. So I'm wishing you all a cool day. And I'll be back. I'm taking next week off. I'm actually going back to this amazing resort that has a lot of nature activities and a lot of art, nature, and mindfulness and hiking. And when I come back, I'm going to have so much more up on my blog and here on Eco Happiness TV to share with you. So again, I'll be back Thursday, July 13th. That's a Tuesday, 10 a.m. Eastern, always right here on Facebook. And again, you can go over to ecohappinessproject.com and enjoy reading all of the posts that are up there. I look forward to seeing you again, and I wish you an amazing, happy week. 2 weeks. Bye, guys.